Hi, I'm Ellen Van Pay. I'm principal at Tank Elementary School here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. One of the things that I enjoyed doing when I was in the classroom was to teach science. And while I taught science, I had the opportunity to partner with NASA. And as a partner of NASA, I worked in two of the different NASA programs. One of the programs was Network of Educator Astronaut Teachers, and a second program was Solar System Educators. I was always the one who had the little micro, you know, that little hand lens out there, and you were, you know, looking at the ants and, you know, collecting the rocks, and you were looking at the butterflies, so you always had the little jars of things. So I did have those, and I was always really curious. I was asking why. One of the things that I was able to do through Network of Educator Astronaut Teachers was take part in an opportunity to experience weightlessness. We partnered with Northrop Grumman to do a zero gravity flight. And on this flight, we went on an airplane that simulated weightlessness. We were able to do 15 parabolic flights where the plane basically goes like this and then comes down, and you experience weightlessness for a short period of time. So we experienced Mars gravity for one of those instances. We experienced the moon's gravity for, I think it was three, and then we experienced 11 different instances of zero gravity. So we first planned experiments that we were going to do with our students, and I partnered with a teacher in Michigan, and she had sixth graders at the time, I had fifth graders. So we planned experiments with our students that we were going to conduct in zero G, and then we went on and videotaped each other within the flight, which was really fun, and you know, you really do have to experience it to understand what it would be like. And then we went back and shared that flight with our students so they could see the results of their experiments. So it was a really neat opportunity to engage the students in something that, you know, students in Green Bay most likely wouldn't have had a chance to do. It was really exciting. You really learned, you know, one of the things that we really wanted to help students understand is for every action there's an equal and opposite reaction. And when you tried to get up, one of the first things you did is you just slammed the ceiling. So you learned that movements would be very, very small. You didn't need to do much. And it helped to understand how, you know, when you launch a rocket from Earth, you really have to work to break away from Earth's gravity. But once it's in space, because it's already got all that thrust, it doesn't need much to continue going. Just tiny little motions to correct its path. It helps you understand how engineers can make spaceflight possible. We had these socks on, and with these socks, there were green, yellow, and blue. And I was in the blue group. And because when you were in zero G, you were spinning so much, you needed to be identified by your sock color, you know, because you were all over the place and try to stay into your area. It's hard to imagine the chaos that it was once you really begin to experience zero G. But it was interesting to see, you know, all the blue sock group and the green sock group, you know, so that was kind of fun.
This one is from my zero G flight. And the neat thing about this is we all had our name tags on upside down when we first went, and then when we actually had conducted the zero G flight, we were able to turn our name tags right side up. Apparently that's a tradition. So that was kind of fun. It made it more official because we were now graduates. We had accomplished what we wanted to. And then this one is more a flight suit that the astronauts would wear. And so it had started out, I believe I got it at Jet Propulsion Lab. And what I started doing was collecting patches from each of the different groups that I went to, different astronauts I met, different missions I was trained on. So, you know, I have my Network of Educator Astronaut badge because that was a group that I was part of. Jet Propulsion Lab is a main center I was a part of, NASA Glenn Research Center. And so I just started adding them on here. Most astronauts will have their major mission patches right up here, and they're not quite so cluttered as this. They just kind of keep them up in one general area. But it's a neat way to collect memories of all the different things that you've done. One of the things that it's fun to remember is even in Green Bay, Wisconsin, it's possible to be connected to the space program. It sometimes seems really far, but if we can help our kids to remember that someday, you know, they could be an astronaut, they could be an engineer, they could be a scientist working for NASA, and explore and open up that possibility, that's really what, in my opinion, it's all about, helping them to explore the things that they could become.